I am Jelle, and last weekend I joined the extra credits game jam. However, there was one slight problem. The jam lasted 3 days and I was just about to go on a trip. So, let me just tell you what happened. It was Friday evening and the next day I had to get up at 3:45 in the morning because the ride would take all day. That way we could arrive at a nice time in the afternoon. I packed my bags and waited for the team reveal. And the team was take care. Okay, let's go. Or I could go to bed, or I could get a little bit of game dev in, or I could get some sleepy time. Well, why do something today if you can do it tomorrow as well? Sleep it is. Okay, let's get ready for a 10-hour drive. The trip went smoothly as I took the first shift, and we were on our way to France. As the sun rose, I started thinking about ideas. The team reminded me of Ludum Dare 46, where the theme was keep it alive. There I made a game about eggs. Check it out if you haven't already. But this time I wanted to do something different. Because I couldn't take my big PC with me, I had to work with what I had. My iPad and my old laptop. A nice and simple 2D game would be perfect. As I was about to take a nap, I saw all these caravans and motorhomes on the road. And I had the perfect idea. You are on a road trip with your family, but your car isn't big enough to fit everyone. So, unfortunately, Granny has to sit in the caravan. Of course, you don't want anything to happen to her, so you will have to drive carefully. Not only are the roads curvy and narrow, but there are others on the road as well, who are racing to get to their destination. So, you better not get hit by them. Okay, so while I was still in the car, I started to draw some vehicles. I started with the cool edgy muscle car, and then I got to the coloring part. I remembered there was an extra credits challenge to use a limited 4-color palette from the old MS-DOS games with the CJ adapter. But then I saw that 4 colors really isn't all that much. Luckily, there was a hack where you could use all 16 colors. So that was what I was going to do as well. What's the fastest color? Red, of course. Next up was the family car. And of course, it was pretty small. Because Granny doesn't fit the, I picked a color that was as far away as possible from red, green. And with the cute car ready, I drew the caravan. When I colored them, I used flat shading with the darker colors from the palette. And I also added highlights to emulate the shininess of the metals and car paints. We were nearing our destination, so I drew a little tileable road texture. Because I've got a great idea about how to make the road. But more on that later. As I finished off my drawings, we arrived at our new home for the week. So I can get my computer and start making games. But first, swimming time! Alright, I've got my legs stretched and I'm ready to start programming. I started with coding the basic car movement. Because I wanted to use physics to move the car around so I can do some crazy hits with the other ones, I based the movement on one of my previous projects, where I control a shopping cart with an Arduino. Only this time, it would be even simpler, because it's only 2D. When I press forward, I apply some force to the cars in the forward direction. And when I turn, I directly affect the rotation and crank up the drag of the car so the sliding gets suppressed. And the car doesn't become an ice cube skimming on a wet floor. Then I did some testing and... well, I have been awake for quite a while already. Next morning, I got bright and... and not that early, because I'm on vacation. Okay, enough of that. Back to making a game. I started off with adding the sprites to the car and began working on the road generation. I used a sprite shape to create a smooth road with very little control points, perfect for fast level creation. And I made sure the tangents of the points were long enough so the corners wouldn't get too sharp. Next up was the main element of the game, the caravan. I tried to add a hinge joint connected to the car. But after trying to control it, and it controlling itself, I realized I did something wrong. I did some other stuff, and after a little while, I thought about adding another rigid body as a tow hook at the back of the car, so the caravan could grab onto that instead. Ah, much better. What a smooth ride. Wait, I need a solution for the abrupt road ending. I didn't want to make different levels and spend time on level design. I don't know if I mentioned that already, but I'm on vacation. So I created a procedural road generation script that would place control points at certain distances away and give the points a random offset in alternate directions. This way, the road becomes an infinite zigzagging road. Now I can drive as long as I want. After all that driving, the road became pretty long, and that's not really useful. Actually, It's really useless. So I created a checkpoint system that if I pass it, it removes the first point and adds the same amount of points at the end. Oh, that's better. Now there are only as much points as I need, all the way to eternity. After that was done, I went back to the pool and called it a day. The third day was also the final day, and there were still a lot of things that I wanted to add. I started with adding the enemy cars and created some basic AI. The AI was programmed to drive towards control points, and once it reaches it, it retargets to the next one, and so on and on and on and on. First, I thought this would be way too easy, since they would all follow the same path, but luckily, physics are really unpredictable and hectic, so the cars just go crazy all the time, perfect for me trying to avoid them. Once the cars would reach the last point on the road, they would be transported back to the beginning. Because they were so hectic, the cars tended to escape the road at the beginning and started to drive next to me, and that's not what I want. So I added the starting place where all the cars would start out and moved it together with the first point so it would always close out the road. Now it was time for some visual indicators. I added a damage system that calculates the car damage based on the impact force of the enemy cars, and added some particles for when the car hits the caravan. I also created different damage states for the caravan, for when its health bar becomes lower than half or 20% respectively. When you see the damage, you know Granny is in big trouble. I also added a distance tracker and made a more precise damage slider. Okay, the game is almost done. I have created the core loop, and to finish things off, I added some tire tracks with a particle system and some cacti along the road. I added a start and end screen, and the game was done. I submitted it to itch.io and got back to the pool. You can play it right now on itch.io and let me know what you think of it. If you like my little vacation jamming, be sure to hit the like button and subscribe if you want to see more videos like this in the future. And I'll see you guys next time, where I will be back at my desk. Bye!